Well, 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 look who's back again for another amazing tutorial. This one's all about FCPX Shift. FCPX Shift is an amazing plugin for creating dynamic, shifting title effects with your footage. And it's easier to use than you'd expect. This plugin contains several categories, each with a different style. Every preset has the same control, so we'll demonstrate everything you can do. Using this preset, Bars 1. Edit mode highlights and numbers each clone layer in the viewer to indicate which layer is which. 0 stands for the first clone layer, while 1 marks the second. So it's great to activate edit mode while making adjustments to the individual clone layers, as we'll see later in the video. Grid title layer applies a kaleidotile effect layer on the media. It's currently visible in the viewer. If we check it off, the effect is removed. Notice the difference? On-screen controls, if checked on, enables controls in the viewer that we can use to adjust the position, rotation, or scale. If the on-screen controls don't immediately show up, simply select the clip. Then select the title once more. We can also use the corresponding controls in the inspector to adjust the same parameters. Mask position adjusts the horizontal or vertical positions of the clone layer mask. Mask rotation controls the angles of the mask. Mask scale determines the size of the mask. Text editable, if checked on, allows us to select and edit the text in the viewer. Text clone repeat, if checked on, creates copies of the text during the animation. It's more apparent if the words are stacked in the text box. Text contents lets us adjust the title text. Text fonts determines the font and style of the text. Text position adjusts the horizontal or vertical position of the text. Text size controls the scale of the text. Text color determines the color of the text. Text slant adds a slant to the text. Next, we can change how the title animation's in or out. In this menu, we can select whether the text will be animated by character, word, line, or all. On the left, the animation applies to each individual letter instead of all the text at once. Animate direction determines the direction that the text will animate. If we freeze the frame here, notice a difference in the placements of the text. Animate spread controls the spread of the animation across each character. Text fade in determines that the text will fade in during the intro. It's very subtle, but if you look closely, you can see the text on the left fade in. Text tracking adjusts the distance between each letter. As we can see, the text is closer together when the value is lower. Text position provides several options for where the text will start while animating. These are just a few possibilities. Simply select the one that looks best for your own project. Text Scale applies a size for the text to start at when it animates in. You can see on the right that the text is much bigger when the value is higher. Down here, the same controls are available for the outro animation of the text. Since we already know how they work, we'll fast forward and show you an example. Pretty cool. And let's see them again in slow motion. Layer amount adjusts the number of mask layers that will be visible. If we set it to 1, we'll remove the top clone layer. Animation timing determines whether the layers will animate with identical timing or staggered, meaning that the timing of each layer will differ slightly from one another. It's a very slight difference, so it's all up to your preference. We'll move on to the next controls. Each of these control groups corresponds to an individual clone layer. Let's change the attributes for the first layer. Position X adjusts the horizontal position of the layer. Position Y determines the vertical position of the layer. Position Z controls the depth of the layer. Rotation Z determines the angle of the layer. Blur Direction adjusts the angle of the blur while the layer animates. On the bottom, notice that the blur moves in a different direction. Blur amount determines how extreme the blur will be during the animation. Notice the intensity of the blur on the right. Now that you're familiar with all these controls, we can't wait to see how you use this plugin.